What's going on here? Extension cord. Kitty, kitty. You'll be scared in a minute. I'm gonna attempt to run the speed queen with electronic controls off the generator. They say not to do that without a power line conditioner. This isn't a Samsung or an LG washing machine. It's a speed queen that's supposed to be commercial grade. So we'll see if it can handle dirty power without damaging it. I got the battery installed. Let's see. So I created a bit of a spark show installing the battery. If I didn't trip a fuse, see, the electric start doesn't, still works. Again, like I said, this is confusing for the thing. That's on, straight up and down. It's hard to interpret that. Go ahead and pull this. That's the choke. Let's see what happens. That still runs. Alright, as you can hear, the generator's running. The controls are on, so it has a memory effect. Heavy duty, second rinse, large soil level. Temp warm. So far it's handling it. Let's see what happens. She is running on generator power. So far. Thank you.
So far, so good. Real test will be during the spin. But it's currently running off of generator power. I don't know why the tub leans. I took it apart, looked at the springs, all attached. The machine's level, so there's nothing I can really do. As long as it washes. spin. Keep in mind, it does low speed spin for the first two, like the first two cycles. So I got an extra rinse. So the first spin and second spin will be low speed, and the final third spin will be high speed. So it's going to be slow for the first two spins. Sounded like it could handle it. I'll have to open the door for the next spin to see if we hear a change in the generator. wasn't a wash, just an itty bitty minor blip out of the generator, almost non-noticeable. You have to kind of be listening for it. See what it sounds like when it goes into spin. I didn't hear any blip from the generator from here, so it's obviously not that noticeable. It's handling it no problem so far. I was wrong. It's going into high speed for the second and third spins. That's about the full 710 RPM right there. So for your main rinse spin and your extra rinse spin, it does the full speed. and the generator's handling it. That's full speed, 710.
Thank you.
just a very, very minor blip. Almost like what it did for the snow blower. And that's it for washing on generator power. Let's go shut the machine down. That's that. Now you shut the switch off. Kill the fuel first so it drains the carburetor. Regardless if you have fuel stabilizer in it or not. Good practice is to shut the fuel off to drain the carb. Then you can hit the switch. Phew, it stinks. So that's that. It handled everything so far. Next I'll obviously be trying to see if it can run the dryer, which is gas, but that'll be later because the pain in the ass to get the plug for it. It's like I literally pull the dryer out, unplug it, then push it back in while trying to line up the exhaust chute. And something I've been toying with too is thinking of getting an electric dryer out here, then use the 240 outlet to run it. But that's a later project if I decide to do it. That's something I've been toying with, but no hurry for that. So, she's a runner. Thanks so much for watching.